So, hey, this is Dr. Story. I've been a chiropractor for over 23 years. I'm going to give you realistic advice based on my experience. I was going through some x-rays for some patients, and I'm going to show you exactly what a reverse cervical curve looks like. Many people don't know really how to evaluate this. I'm going to show you exactly how we do this, what we look for, and how to know if you can fake these things, because many times people think that, well, I can actually just raise my chin or change my position and have a reverse cervical curve. I'm going to show you exactly why you can't do that. So I turned out the lights here, and what I'm looking at right now is I'm looking at an x-ray that I took of a patient that just got in a car accident. And what we're looking at is we're looking at her x-ray. This is the back of her head right here. This is her jaw. Now, if you notice, the jaw and the orientation of the eyes are straight ahead. If she was gonna try to fake this, she would have to kind of tuck her chin in or drop her head, her jaw, and her head would be up like this. But you can see that she's not doing that. Also, this is the first bone right here of the neck. That's called the atlas. And right here is called the axis bone. Now, a normal cervical curve, a normal C shape, should have a C shape, okay? So I'm gonna use my hand here to give you an idea. A C shape meaning a C. So if you were to present yourself and you had a normal curve, there would be some amount of curve right there. Now, what we can do here on this x-ray, I'm gonna get up real close, is I'm gonna show you probably likely, and we'd have to examine the patient to determine this, where the actual injury occurred. Now, this is number two, this is number three, number four, number five, number six, number seven, and T1. So when we look at someone's x-ray, first thing we notice is obviously she lost the cervical curve. That's called a military neck. Now, the individual spaces in between the bones are the disc materials. And the discs are what the bones are sitting on. Right here, these things that are sticking out, these are the things that you can actually feel yourself. If you put your hand on the back of your head, you can actually feel these bumps, and that's what you feel is the spine. Now, there is a reverse cervical curve here, and most of the trauma and injury actually occurred, let's see, 2, 3, 4, 5, between 5 and 6. You can see how the shape of the disc is actually abnormal compared to the others. And then number four is slightly forward compared to number five, and that may indicate ligament instability. We'd have to do another study in order to find out if that's true. One of the interesting things about this is look how cramped the atlas bone is to the occiput. And this patient came in and said that they had pretty tremendous headaches. It's very likely we're gonna be adjusting an anterior occiput here, as well as staying below that injury site where ligament instability occurs. I'll probably be adjusting her C6. And as a general rule, this works very well. But I wanted to show you what exactly a military neck looks like. And that's how you can see it on an x-ray.